A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 22nd July, on the front page you have solar panel vendors cash in on power demand during Assam floods. So some traders in areas that usually escape inundation invested in solar gadgets before the arrival of monsoon in June. And here you can see these solar gadgets are being in demand now. When due to floods, power is being cut. Then you have revamp of army headquarters to get underway by month end. So government has already given in principle nod to revamp the army headquarters. So this is expected to reorganization of army headquarters would take place by the month end. So this is the first of the four measures being undertaken as part of transformation of the force. So the other four, three measures have also been mentioned here, you can see. Another major change is also the Directorate of Military Operations, Military Intelligence. These would be, you know, will look after all technology and cyber related issues. A new post of Additional Director General Vigilance is being created that will report to the Army Chief. Then next, government to roll out big push for infrastructure. So major decisions outlined as NDA completes 50 days in office in second term are here listed below, you can see. So the annual Global Investors Summit is to be organized later this year, and National Investment in Infrastructure Fund NIF will be anchoring the event to invite investment in the infrastructure sector. So spending for the next 5 years in infra is projected at 100 crore rupees. So big push for infrastructure is being undertaken by the present government. This is little room for SCST scientists in biotech bodies. So RTI inquiry reveals poor representation of SCs and STs in science in biotech bodies. So that is listed out here. On page 7 you have center's decision to bring amendments to RTI Act draws criticism from activists. They call the bill a move to undermine independence of information commissions. So we discussed this yesterday too, when we discussed the RTI bill. Then below you have 20 lakh children to get rotavirus vaccine. So every infant will be given vaccine in 6th, 10th and 14th week according to the Ministry of Health. So initiatives have been taken to prevent childhood deaths. And this is in Maharashtra, where vaccination against rotavirus will be provided to all children. So 20 lakh children. On page 8 you have center revoked aid request for Amravati project, World Bank. So 3 days after it emerged that World Bank dropped without reason its plan to finance the Amravati Sustainable Infrastructure and Institutional Development Project, the World Bank has now stated that the government of India, central government, withdrew its request regarding the project. So that's why it was dropped. Chief Minister's office blames it on corruption. On page 9 you have moon mission to try landing on September 7. So targeted date is just a day later than the earlier schedule of September 6, and the module's twin phases have been tweaked now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is sucking up surplus. So this is regarding how SEBI is being called by the central government to provide 75% of its surplus that should be transferred to the central government. So this editorial says that SEBI needs financial autonomy to remain effective as the chief market regulator. And if its money is taken away from it, to which it makes payments, then its autonomy would be affected. And here you have a new beginning. So this is regarding pact between military and civilian protesters in Sudan. So it says this may help Sudan turn a democracy. So this has been in international news for long regarding how Sudan's ruling military council and as such and the representatives of pro-democracy movements now have signed a power sharing agreement. Earlier there were protests going on by the pro-democracy representatives and Sudan's military had used force against them. Then the lead article is the tremor of unwelcome amendments. So this is regarding the RTI amendment bill. It is called a twin attack on accountability and idea of federalism. So this is a very important article. And this is an ally, a partner, and American unilateralism. So it says there are major differences but also similarities in US response to Russia's S-400 deal with Turkey and India. So how America is responding to it? So the differences and similarities are being listed down here. On op-ed page you have ignoring the proportionality principle. So the High Court's verdict in the Shakti Mill rape case disregards several judicial standards and precedents. This is discussed in this article. It's the Bombay High Court which last month gave judgment upholding the validity of Section 376E of IPC, which authorizes award of either a life sentence or a death penalty to perpetrators upon a second rape conviction. So, the High Court's reasoning, what it did is proportionality of the punishment was looked into. So, the High Court reasoning in upholding the law, it says, is open to criticism. The constitutional standard that courts must apply when testing laws on the touchstone of Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution is that of proportionality. So, in the context of criminal law and sentencing, proportionality asks whether a particular punishment strikes an adequate balance between gravity of the crime, the interests of the victim and society, and the purpose of criminal law. So, this is this article of granting death sentence under Section 375E of IPC is criticized in this article. And this is an invasive and inefficient tool. So, use of facial recognition technology in law enforcement, it says, can have disastrous consequences. So, this is regarding AFRS, Automated Facial Recognition System, which has recently been proposed by the Home Ministry, which will use even CCTV images. On page 13, you have Center's JNK playbook goes down to the grassroots. So, central government wants to move away from past set pieces and break political hegemonies, but and put different actors on the political chessboard in Jammu and Kashmir is what is being observed here. And this is Niti Aayog's health index suffers from skews. So, use of estimated figures in place of reported numbers have affected the final score of certain states. So, this is being reported how there is a skew in the Niti Aayog health index. And this is India-Iran discuss release of sailors. So, expecting response to the note or bill which India has sent to Iran is what is being stated here. On international page you have don't escalate tensions, Iran tells UK. So it says this is quite dangerous and unwise at a sensitive time in the region, that you know the British flagged ship which has been captured by Iran. So this was illegally passing oil. So that is the allegation. Indian sailors are also on this ship, that is why India has also sent a note to Iran to get their release. Then this is protesters deface Beijing's office in Hong Kong. So now again the defacing of the Beijing office has been seen. So this is seen as a direct challenge to city's political masters. So Hong Kong protests have further escalated now and taken a new dimension. Then there is no important news on the business page and the last page has sports coverage. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.